So let's continue studying motions of Steiner circles associated with various types of Möbius transformations. Currently, we are considering the transformation given by formula 1. We have determined the fixed points of this transformation, fixed points 0 and I. Now we have written the normal form of this transformation. Here is the normal form associated with this fixed points. And now the next step, we want to determine the factor lambda in order to know what kind of transformation it is and what kind of motion of Steiner circles is associated with this transformation. So how do we find lambda? Very easy. We see the normal form of this transformation, and it's enough for us to find any image and pre-image, and take any pre-image and find the associated image by formula 1, and then we can substitute this z and w in formula star and find the respective lambda from there. So I will choose any z except of course the fixed points. We will find the respective WTZ. So we will find it from this formula. So W equals negative Z over 1 plus I Z minus I, that will be when Z equals to I. This is our choice. Could we take a different number? Yes, we could. But we want to take some really easy numbers. So let's put it here. So it will be negative of negative I will be I divided by 1 plus I multiplied by negative I and minus I. We can reduce the numerator and denominator by I, so we will have 1 over negative 1 minus I and minus I. So it will be negative 1 over 1 plus 2i. And in order to find this product, we multiply and divide by the conjugate. I hope I did not make any mistakes. So we multiply and divide by 1 minus 2i. 1 minus 2i. So it will be negative 1 minus 2i divided by the modulus squared of the denominator of the 1 plus 2i. 1 squared plus 2 squared. So it will be negative 1 plus 2i divided by 5. So we will substitute z equals negative I and w is negative 1 plus negative 1 minus 2. Just take W equal negative 1 plus 2i. I will use this, bring this negative in the numerator, divide it by 5. This will be some value of z, and its image. Let's see I did it. I made a mistake somewhere. Maybe. Yeah. Oh yes, I made a mistake. One second, I'm sorry. It's always a good idea to find, to take two different points. Where is my mistake? Where is my mistake? Here's my mistake. I reduced the whole fraction. I divided numerator and denominator by I. So here is I is gone, is left negative 1. So negative 1 minus I is good. And here I is gone, so it will be minus 1. So it will be negative 1 over 2 plus I. Right? Negative 2 minus I. We factored out negative here. So we multiply by 2 minus I divided by 2 minus I. So it will be negative 2 minus I divided by 2 squared plus 1 squared. So it will be negative 2 plus I divided by 5. You see, compared with my records, it looks good. It does look right. Now, here's our numbers. Z is negative I, and W is negative 2 plus I divided by 5. This is a pair which we can use. We'll substitute this into the star formula to find lambda. These are the numbers we will substitute into the asterisk formula. So what do we have? W minus 2 plus I divided by 5. Write very carefully, make it very clear what's going on. Divided by minus 2 plus I divided by 5 minus I equals lambda. Here will be negative I. So Z divided by negative I, negative I. Negative I minus I. So what it is going to be? I will bring my calculations here. Don't do this. I can multiply by 5 numerator and denominator of this fraction. So it will be minus 2 plus I divided by minus 2 plus I and minus 5i equals lambda multiplied by, we just multiply, we divide numerator and denominator by negative I, we will have 1 over 1 plus 1. So it will be 1 half. Right? So from here, lambda equals 2 multiplied by negative 2 plus I divided by negative 2 minus 4. Or it will be negative 2 plus I divided, reduced by 2. We can actually write here. We can factor out negative from the denominator and be reduced by 2. It will be 1 plus 2i. 1 plus 2i. And we will multiply by 1 minus 2i. We will multiply by 1 minus 2i. So what is it going to be? You have negative, let's just multiply through. Negative 2 plus 4i plus I minus 2i squared divided by 1 squared plus 2 squared equals. What's in the numerator? Negative 2. And negative 2 multiplied by negative 1 will cancel each other. And we have 4i plus I is 5i. We have negative before everything. Don't forget this negative. Negative before everything. And here we will have 5i divided by 5. So it will be negative I. So lambda is equal to negative I. Or it's clear that the modulus of lambda is equal to 1. You can present it in the exponential form. It will be, I will write here, lambda equals e to the power negative I pi over 2. This is our lambda. This is our lambda. And this lambda tell that transformation T is elliptic. Transformation T is elliptic. So what's going to happen next? We want to see the motions of the Steiner circles. It's pretty clear that what happens in the in this transformation in the plane of capital letters. Happens here in the Z W capital plane, yeah, where Z is S. I can write what is Z is S, what we used to denote S Z, or it is Z minus 0 divided by Z minus I. So what happens in this plane? In this plane, one of our fixed points, 0, comes to the origin, and I goes to infinity. And we will have a bunch of lines that are going through the origin. So, right? The origin to infinity. This is the Z plane and also W capital plane. So what happens as a result of this transformation? The lines are being rotated through the angle negative pi over 2. So I would say, for instance, this line rotates into this line, right? So angle negative pi over 2. Or let's say this line is being rotated into the angle negative pi over 2. This line is being rotated into this line. Yes, it goes in the negative direction. Negative pi over 2. And so on and so on. So you can take any other line. For instance, take this line and suppose this is going very well. This line. is the image of this line, right? The image I will show this line. What will be the image of this line? It will be a line perpendicular, so I will draw a line at right angle. As a result of transformation, W equals E negative I pi over 2z. This line, for instance, will go into this line, rotated, so negative pi over 2. That's what will happen. And our question is, what is the motion in the ZW small plane? That's what we want to depict in our diagram. I think I can erase practically everything to have room for writing. I can leave this formula still here. I can write here that lambda is, now we know it, e to the power negative I pi over 2, right? The transformation is elliptic. And what I would like to do as well, I would like to draw the original, some original Steiner circles, some original Steiner circles of the first kind, because these lines are images of the Steiner circles of the first kind. And the rotation goes along these circles, along Steiner circles of the second kind. So it goes with this rotation, for instance, goes along a circle like this. Yeah? This rotation goes like this. And this rotation goes this along a circle, yes, along an arc of the circle of a second kind of Apollonius circle. Yeah. So our fixed points are 0 and I. So suppose I is here. So we have circles of the first kind. Are circles passing through I and 0. So for instance, I would say this circle with the center lying right on the imaginary axis. This circle is one of them. Well, difficult to draw a circle, but to draw a circle passing through certain points is rather difficult. I think it looks okay. It looks mostly okay. Yeah? So, this is a circle. I will give it name Gamma 1 because I have to give it some name. This is a circle Gamma 1. There may be other circles passing through these points and we will, and you can look at their motions as well. For instance, I will draw a circle like this. Yeah, no, there are infinitely many circles. All their centers lie along this line passing in the middle between them. Yeah, so I would like to see, for instance, how Gamma 1 moves And gamma 1, I can write an equation of this circle. The equation of this circle is, evidently this is the midpoint between 0 and I, so it will be z minus I over 2 modulus is equal to 1 half. This will be formula, I will denote it the same way I denote it here. It is formula number 5. So I would like to know what's happening with this circle. So I will ask the following questions. You know what happens with our motions? Our motion can be viewed. We have z plane. By means of transformation S we come to the z plane, then z by transformation R becomes W capital, and W capital becomes W by transformation S minus 1. Right? That's how it works. So what is the image of gamma 1? What's S of gamma 1 in Z plane? What's the image of gamma 1 in Z plane? So the equation of gamma 1 is number 5. I will write it later, but so far I want to do the transformation S. It's written like this. Z over Z minus I. Z over Z minus I equals to Z. From here I can find z and substitute into this equation of the circle. So express z from here. So it will be z equals, I multiply by z minus I, z z minus I z. So z multiplied by 1 minus, or maybe I better take it to the right hand side. I z I will take here equals z multiplied by z minus 1, or z equals I z divided by z minus 1. And of course z conjugate, you need it, will be negative I z conjugate divided by z conjugate minus 1. These two we will substitute into, I think I will take equation 6, I over 2 modulus squared is equal to 1 quarter. I just take the square of this equation because we don't like squares. Right? So z minus I over 2 multiplied by z conjugate plus I over 2 equals 1 quarter. Now we'll substitute these expressions. So it will be I z divided by z minus 1 minus I over 2 multiplied by negative I z divided by z minus 1 plus I over 2 equals 1 quarter. And I think, sorry, this is conjugate, so this must be conjugate. This must be conjugate, right? Plus, I hope I did not make mistakes. Then we just bring this to common denominator. So we have 2iz minus iz minus 1 divided by 2z minus 1 multiplied, what we get here, negative 2iz conjugate plus iz conjugate and minus I divided by 2z conjugate minus 1 and equals to 1 quarter. Right? Now, what will I do now? To erase something, I think I will erase this. This now I will multiply. I can reduce the fraction by 4 because we have 2 times 2, 4 in the denominator, and there 4 in the denominator. And I multiply the whole equation by z minus 1, z conjugate minus 1. So, what will I have here? What will I have here? 2iz minus iz will be iz minus I multiplied by negative 1 plus I in the numerator is multiplied. What's here? Negative iz conjugate and minus I, right? Minus I z conjugate and minus I equals, and this will be z minus 1 z conjugate minus 1. So when I multiply this through, I will have I times negative I is 1, z conjugate. I times negative I is 1 plus z conjugate and minus my negative I multiplied by I is 1 plus 1 equals z conjugate minus z conjugate and plus 1. It's not too bad. I can cancel the z conjugate on both sides of the equation, 1 and 1, and then I bring these two guys here and I will have 2 z plus z conjugate equals to 0, which means exactly that real part of z equals to 0. This is the equation of S of gamma 1. So the image of gamma 1 as a result of S transformation goes into the imaginary axis. that's our discovery. That is our discovery. That is our discovery. And then, of course, we have to perform the transformation W equals E negative I over 2Z. And this transformation, in ZW plane, what does it do, this transformation? I will draw this. This is the image. S of gamma 1. Gamma 1 is this circle which sits right in the middle. This for which this distance between fixed points is the diameter. Yes, this is our gamma 1. This. So what happens as a result of this transformation? Right? It's being rotated through negative 90 degrees. It means it's being rotated like this. Opa. Negative I over 2. And of course this. So, what is the image? This real axis. So, R of S of gamma 1 is the real axis. What is the equation of the real axis? The equation of the real axis is imaginary part of W capital is equal to 0. Now we have to apply what happens when we apply transformation S minus 1 in the W plane. W plane is our original plane, yes, we'll return to our native plane, that small w, that's where transformation T occurs, it makes W smalls out of Z. So I think we can erase all of this stuff. And we can say, this is our equation, imaginary of W equals to 0, or W minus 0 divided by W minus I is equal, imaginary part of this is equal to 0. Right? You know how to write equation, imaginary part of W is 0, it will be, what is imaginary part of W? 1 over 2i, W minus W conjugate is equal to 0. That's how we express imaginary part, yes? So, this expression minus its conjugate must be 0. So, W, I will not write minus 0, it's ridiculous, yes? I'm just writing this to remind you what are our fixed points. So, W. W minus 1 minus W conjugate divided by W conjugate plus I equals to 0. Multiply by W minus 1 W conjugate plus I. So give W conjugate plus I minus W conjugate W minus I equals to 0. Right? Did I make mistake somewhere here. I hope I did not. So we will have W conjugate plus I W minus W conjugate W and plus I W conjugate is equal to 0. These two cancel each other. We can divide by I both sides of the equation. We have W plus W conjugate is equal to 0. That's the equation of our Klein. Or this equation can be written as real part of W is equal to 0. This equation. I just want to see what number is in my notes. Number 11, right? Number 11. So in the notes are more consistent numeration. So, as a result of all these transformations being applied, I think I will erase this intermediate part, and I will say we had this circle gamma 1, and we applied transformation S of gamma 1, then we apply transformation R, and then we apply to this transformation S minus 1, we obtained real part W equals 0. The imaginary axis. And imaginary, there is nothing strange about it, because the imaginary axis is one of these lines connecting the two fixed points, yes? So, if I look at this circle gamma 1, I will make it more prominent looking. What happens? This circle, its image has become this circle. I also use a black pencil and I will make it just more visible. This axis. Imaginary axis. How do we show that imaginary gamma 1 looks into imaginary axis? You can show it like this. It must go along the Apollonius circles, along the circles that are orthogonal to our Steiner circles of first kind. You can see here one of them. This is certainly one of them, because this is a Klein, right? It's a straight line. Moreover, this straight line is right in the middle between the fixed points. It will stay the same way. You can check that in ZW plane it will become the unit circle. And here the motion occurs along the Apollonius circles, yes? So you can see that motion will go like this. What are other motions? What are other motions? How will they go? Will they go? Will they go from gamma 1 to the imaginary axis, yes? Will they go like this, for instance? Will they go like this, or how? How will they go? And in order to see, will they go, for instance, like this? And in order to see how these circles will move, we need to draw a few, at least a few, maybe one, circles of the second kind, or what you call Apollonian circles. Apollonian circles. How Apollonian circles will go? They go so that points I and 0 are symmetric in them. So will be circle like this, will be proper circle like this, will be a circle like this, will be a circle like this, and so on, right? But it's a good idea to draw at least one circle to see precisely what's happening then. And we will do it in the next lecture.